What's up everybody and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, we're gonna be doing a modification on our cars that we've wanted to do probably since we were 10 years old. We got the GTR here and we got the Audi R8. And this is gonna be pretty sweet.
So we're gonna be installing underglow and we're gonna show you how to properly do this. We've seen over the last probably decade, people can really rice out the underglow lighting, but we wanna make it proper just like the Skyline in Fast and Furious.
Yes.
Have that nice ring of glow or the glow color running around the entire exterior. So this is gonna be a pretty sweet mod.
So let's show you guys the kit that we got. And this is all from 1UP Lighting. You can see their name. We'll have this all linked down below. They have a ton of items, underglow kits, interior kits, and all sorts of goodies like that. But you can see this kit all put together. This is the brains of it. You have a QR code that you scan on your phone and you do an app.
We got all the hardware zip ties, which we may or may not use, just depending on the location.
Yeah, there's two in each of these.
Yeah.
We have different ones that have a connection on it as well as ones that have actual ends. So we can really piece this together. So for the GTR, I'm gonna go ahead and start taking my front bumper off. It works out well because I gotta clean my air filters. So this is a good excuse to get the air filters out. We're just gonna take all these bolts on the underside out and then just pull off this plastic tab underneath the car. Just straight up here, we can take that one off too. And then behind the reflectors, there is a small Phillips head screw. And then we just got a handful of these little plastic tabs on the top of the radiator cover. And that piece comes right out. And then underneath that, we just have a few more, and that is officially disconnected. So from there, we're just gonna pull the bottom of the bumper up, and same with the top. But my idea for the GTR, since I have a massive front mount intercooler, I'm gonna actually mount one of the strips in here to illuminate the intercooler inside the grill, which is gonna look really, really aggressive, I think. And then all I'm gonna do is the underglow for the sides of the car to keep this a little bit more subtle and I think a performance look. So the way I'm gonna do this, with these two panels out of the way, you can see this plug right here. This is the end of the battery tender that I have hardwired into my battery. You can see the fuse right here, the cable going to the positive, and then this cable going to the negative. So basically what I'm gonna do is hardwire this kit using the little gator clips that my battery tender kit came with. I'll have all this linked down below as well. So with all the soldering out of the way, I went ahead and then electrical taped it so everything is nice and neat. So next up, you're gonna wanna take your phone and scan the QR code that's on this and get the app running on your phone. So plugging it in. All right, so now they're on. And as you can see, if you come up close, with the app, I can easily adjust everything with the different colors. You can see the greenish color. So after doing some more mapping out and getting everything lined up, I'm using the ends that came with a capped off piece for my sides, because if you come under here and take a look, underneath my jack points, there's actually a perfect location to slide this right in between them, as you can see. So I'm just starting all the way at the end, and luckily the GTR has this piece of plastic. It's just plastic under here, nothing under it or anything important near it. And we're just gonna go down this entire inner edge. Now this kit also comes with these little rubber anchors and a bunch of screws and zip ties. What I'm gonna do is take the screw and just put it through one end of this silicone piece. And then underneath the car, I'm only drilling three holes into my car. And again, this is just plastic. There's no function to it. And if you look really close, if you can zoom in, I'm actually sandwiching this screw in between the plastic piece and the metal subframe. So it's kind of like an anchor without having to actually drill a hole. And then from there, I'm just taking that silicone piece and kind of wrapping it over itself. And this is going to be extra security. And then I'll just screw it in place. And now that this piece is nice and secure, just in case the adhesive ever fails, you know, I have three anchors. I did one in the center and one towards the back. So the 3M tape is gonna do a good job, but now at least it's kind of anchored, so they're never gonna hang. So to work on feeding wires, you just want to use a metal snake like this. And we fed this under my intercooler and we're able to get this cable perfectly. It's like the right length. We got it through basically the underside of the control arm. So it's a nice straight shot, nothing interfering with it. From there, I'm just gonna leave it there. We have cleaned all this whole plastic area with the grease remover, but this one at least should be out of the way enough, because the goal is to not see the actual lights. That's where people ruin it with these kits. When you see the lights, you kind of make it look like crap, so this should look pretty good like that. So then fast forward to this evening, we have it all set up, and just to show you once again how I have it set up with the two different plugs, one coming from the battery and the other coming from the system. So I like how this way kind of gives me that freedom to either use the kit or not even have it connected, and I can easily tuck it back away and then put the cover back on if needed. So with that said, let me show you how it all works. Very easily it pairs. Let me just tap one of the colors and turn it on, and we'll just take a quick look at the car. I like how subtle I've made it. It's not too crazy, but I love that intercooler. Just look how cool that looked. But there's also so many different ways you can do this with different colors, all sorts of crazy colors you can do. And then there's even different modes and everything. But I really like how it's coming together. You can even adjust some more of them and have all sorts of crazy things happening. So that is definitely pretty cool, the way everything is set up. So now let's hop over to the Audi R8 and get that car looking cool.
All right guys, so it's a new day. We are onto the R8 now, and I'm doing the same connection as the GTR. So I have this plug here. Now just to note, the kit itself is a direct plug and play system. So from this module here, you'll hook up positive to positive, negative to negative, directly to your battery. If you're doing some kind of plug system like we're doing, it might be flip-flop due to the polarity of the LEDs, but the kit itself is plug and play, so it's really easy to hook up. And then for my lighting, I'm gonna go with four lights for right now. I have these strips going in a big circle, so we only have one going up into the battery. I have a long one on the sides, and then a short one in the back, and a short one in the front. I think this is gonna look really cool, a little bit different from the GTR, just because we have different designs, different areas in the front and the rear. So for my car, we're gonna start on the front end here. And it's really nice that up underneath the bumper, I actually have some bodywork hidden behind this little shield here. So if I do scrape, this is normally what I hit. And we're gonna use this white section here. It curves a little bit on both sides, but this will really illuminate the front end of the car and make it look really cool. So I'm looking at this screw on the curve here. Mm-hmm. I wanna try to center it with that curve there. So you're good on that side?
Yeah, I gotta say, I really like how flexible everything is. I'll show you guys a better, closer look. Look at that going around the entire curve. Like nothing. Now, like we mentioned with the GTR, there's the snake we're using, and we've already poked it through a hole in the bottom in between two of the panels, and then we've taped on the cable that we need to get into the car. And from here, you can see the snake is that metal piece right there. Oh, I see it. There we go. So with the cable all now in the trunk, we're just gonna feed the snake through that really skinny hole all the way down, and that is gonna come out from the perspective down here, just underneath the control arm. And then from there, I actually have the plug and everything tucked underneath this. There's like a hole in here when I peel this back. So excess wire is now behind this plastic trim piece, and then that's just sandwiched underneath the skid plates, underneath the control arm, and then going right up into the trunk.
So with this last one here, it's a little bit interesting because we have a lot of curves in my under skid plate, but I think this is gonna work. We'll see how the lighting is later, but this is one solid piece. So when I go to do an oil change, we don't have to worry about taking this off. But I am going to use these little brackets that came with the kit, especially in these hard curved areas. The adhesive may come off just because of how curved it is. So I'm gonna do two on each side. This is just plastic, so there's nothing on the backside of it. We have the car on the ground now, and just to show you, here is my connection so I can easily access them and put this to my battery tender or these lights. And with the app, obviously during the daytime here, it's going to be hard to see, but all of the lights work. They are currently red. And now I think we have so many different colors. This is gonna be so cool to mess with later tonight. So going back to nighttime now for the R8, I found this random pattern that's going around all of these lights. And this is exactly what I was going for when I pictured putting all these lights on my car. It has good coverage in the front bumper, good coverage on the sides. And then in the rear, the only thing I'm going to say is that if you are all the way down here, you can see a little bit of that LED wrapping around that, but no one's really ever going to be that low. But there are so many settings that I've been going through. This is a cool one here. And as you saw earlier, we can do different colors like red, blue, there's pink, yellow, and all of these random patterns to go through. This is going to be pretty cool. Of course, I'm not going to drive around like this. I'll have more of these solid colors or going to a car show or something like that, like we already mentioned. But definitely a pretty sweet mod for the R8.
All right, and now back to the current day. So overall, this is a really simple project, maybe 2 hours each car.
Maybe three.
It's pretty simple once you kind of know what you're doing. One-up lighting kit works so well, and all the crazy colors, combinations really kind of liven up the cool experience of having the underglow. And this is definitely great for photo shoots of your car, you know, going to car shows in the evening time. Just a cool way to spruce up the car a little bit and add some flair. And I love the way we've done it on these to where we can disconnect them if we don't want to use them. And I think they both came out really good. Obviously you just saw it at night, but the GTR looked awesome lighting up the intercooler. And then the underside looks really cool. R8 looks super sweet as well with the underside and then the front and the rear. So very, very cool kit. Definitely look into this if you want a fun little way to spruce up the car. So I think that is then it, how to properly install the LED underglow on your car. Check out 1UP Lighting, we'll have their link down below. Certainly check them out. If you guys enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you guys in the next video.